Hello students, today we are going to start our next chapter, chapter number 3, that is two stories about flying. It means in this chapter we are going to read two stories which are related to flying. There are two parts. First part, his first flight, that is written by Lamb or Flirty, and second one is Black Aeroplane. So students, today we will study only this part. First part, his first flight. His is seagull here. Okay, it means this story is related to the first flight of the seagull. Let us read something about Lamb or Flirty. He was an Irish novelist and short story writer. He was born on 28 August 1896 and breathed his last on 7 September 1984. He was born in a remote village of Goat Nag Campal in Galway. He wrote a famous novel, The Informer, in 1925. His novel, Return of Brute, was also a great success. He was a founding member of Communist Party of Ireland. He was fond of traveling. Beta, all of we have heard that a journey of 1,000 miles begin with a single step. In this chapter, we are going to read about a young seagull that is afraid to fly for the first time. He believes that his wings would not support him. Despite his younger siblings flying fearlessly with much shorter wings, he could not gather the courage to do the same. He was punished to stay hungry if he did not try. Thus, it was his mother that compelled him to fly by using food as a trap. The lesson reflects how one hesitates to take the first step and that fear is all in the mind. One should trust one's abilities because the fear of suffering is worse than the suffering itself. It means we should not be afraid of anything. We should have the courage to do the thing. Let us start this chapter. His first flight. The young seagull. Beta, seagull is a sea bird that actually rules the sky. Because of its wings span, and they hunt fish. They are found around the sea. Was alone on his ledge. Ledge means a narrow horizontal shelf projecting from a wall, or here it means a cliff. His two brothers and sisters had already flown away the day before. It means he was having two brothers and one sister, and they had already flown away the day before. He had been afraid to fly with them. He did not get the courage to fly with them. He was very afraid. Somehow, when he had taken a little run forward to the brink of the ledge, later brink here means coast, bank, kinara of the ledge, and attempt to flap his wings, he became afraid. Means somehow he tried to fly, but when he came near the ledge, at the end of the ledge, and flapped his wings again, he became afraid. The great expanse here means spread of the sea stretched down beneath. He was able to see the great sea around that cliff, and it was such a long way down, miles down, and he felt certain that his wings could never support him, as he did not have the courage. So he thought that his wings would not support him. So he bent his head and ran back to the little hall under the ledge where he slept at night. As he got afraid, just after that, he ran back to the little hole where he used to sleep at night. Even when each of his brothers and his little sister, whose wings were far shorter than his own, ran to the brink. Brink, beta, here means the edge. The edge of the that hill. The edge of the hill. Flapped their wings and flew away. He failed to muster up. Muster up means gather the courage to take that plunge. Plunge means jump here, which appeared to him so desperate. And his father and mother had came around. He was having father and mother. When they saw it, they came near to him. Mother had come around, calling him shrilly. Shrilly here means that in a very shrill voice, harsh voice, they were upbraiding. Upbraiding means they were scolding him. They were threatening him to let him starve, let him hungry on his legs unless he flew away. But for the life of him, he could not move. Though he was scolded by the parents, he was threatened by the parents that they would not be providing him the food, but he did not move from his place as he was really afraid to fly. That was 20 hours ago. Since then, nobody had come near. Means 24 hours had passed, but nobody came near to him, near the seagull. The day before, all day long, he had watched his parents flying about with his brothers and sister, perfecting them in the art of flight, teaching them how to skim. Skim here means to move lightly just above a surface. Skim the weeds and how to dive for fish. Dive means dive into the water for the fish. So, beta, the day before, all day long, he observed that his parents were flying with his brothers and sisters and they were teaching them the art of flying. They were teaching them how to skim the waves and how to dive to take the fish out of the water. He had in fact seen his older brother catch his first herring. Herring here means a soft finned sea fish, a kind of fish, and devour it. Devour here means eat quickly. He saw him eat, catching the fish and eating them quickly, standing on a rock, while his parents circled around, raising a proud crackle. His parents were moving around those brothers, sisters, and they were making crackle means sound here. They were making a proud sound. They were really very happy that they have taught their other children to fly, to dive, and to catch the fish. And all the morning, the whole family had walked about on the big plateau, midway down the opposite cliff, taunting him with his cowardice. Cowardice means for the lack of bravery. And all the morning, the whole family walked about on the big plateau. They were moving on the plateau midway down the opposite, in the opposite side of the cliff. On one cliff, seagull was there. On the opposite side, another cliff was there. And from there, they were taunting him with his cowardice, that he was so coward that not able to take his first flight. In this way, they were not happy and they were taunting him. Why they were taunting him? Because they wanted him to be teased so that he will get the courage to fly. He was now ascending. Ascending means rising the sky and blazing on his ledge. Ledge, you can see better this part. This part of the cliff is called ledge. Okay, that faced the south direction. He felt the heat because he had not eaten since the previous nightfall. It means the sun had now risen and he was feeling the heat more than ever because he was empty stomach since last night before. He stepped out of his ledge slowly, okay, and standing on one leg with the other leg hidden under his wings. But this is the way the seagull sleep. They sleep on one leg. One of the leg they hide under their wings and another they put the complete weight of their body. And he closed one eye and then the other. It means he was pretending to sleep. He wanted to show his parents that he is sleeping and he wanted to attract their attention also. But no one noticed. Still, they took no notice of him. They did not observe him. He saw his brothers and his sisters lying on the plateau, dozing. Dozing means sleepiness, with their heads sunk into their necks. His father was preening. Preening means making an effort to maintain the feathers, means to clean the feathers. Preening the feathers on his white back. Only his mother was looking at him. As you know, mothers are always soft-hearted. Only the mother was looking at him. She was standing on a little high hump on the plateau. Here, hump means a rounded, raised mass of earth or land. You might have seen the hump of the camel. That is also the raised part. Her white breast thrust forward. Now and again, he tore at a piece of fish that lay at her feet, then scrapped here means discarded each side of her beak on the rock. The sight of the food maddened him. How he loved to tear food that way, scrapping his beak now and again to wet it. Wet it means to sharp it. So Beta, in this paragraph, the writer says that nobody noticed him when he was pretending to sleep. His siblings were sleeping. His father was cleaning with his beak, his feathers, and his mother was standing on the another plateau and she was eating the fish while she noticed him. The seagull got mad on seeing the fish because he was very hungry. He loved to tear away fish and scrape his beak now and then to sharp.